Happy Saturday, guys. I'm in front of my natural lighted window, so hopefully this light will be a little bit better today. But I'm sitting down a little bit low. So we're putting on primer while everybody hops on. If anybody hops on. Hi, Connie. We're just going to get ready today. Hey, Miss Ramona. How is everybody? Hi, Marissa. Hi, Mom. You not working downstairs today, Mom? You know I've got to say it. It's hot in here. I even have the fan on. Hey. Hi, Linda. I'm in front of my window, so I'm hoping this will give me good light, and I have the fan right above me. Good morning. Good noon morning time. Thanks, Connie. I pinned my website. I don't know that I'm going anywhere or doing anything today, but just in case when little Mr. Glenn gets off some, we just may go to dinner, or I want to see the new Roger Rabbit. Is that what it is? It's still dark. I don't like that. Oof. What is, I cannot ever get good light. Never. I'm just going to give up. Oh well. That's too dark. I know, it is my morning. Hey, watching from the barn while waiting on horses to get done eating. Yay! Yes, Connie was on it. Yes, Jen! Oh well. What is wrong with my lighting? I don't know. We're going to go with it. We're just doing it. It'll go in and out and get brighter and darker, and it is what it is. You're playing Sudoku, or Sudoku, however you say that. Yes, I touched the screen. Yep, I'm in front of the natural lighted window today, and I thought, oh, that will work better, because when I sit down, it looked better, see? But then you move your hand one way, or sneeze, or breathe, and it changes the lighting, so... We are dealing with it.com here at the Bowles house, we say. So we're putting on makeup. Sissy has a, hi Carla. I was talking with one of these girls. Hi Tammy. Hi Nicole. Sissy has a live tonight. I'm always at dinner when she's doing that. Like I eat at like midnight or something. Thanks Jen, I'm so excited. I couldn't do it without you girls and your support. It is truly exciting. I'm like, oh my gosh. Within a few days over a month, I earned the crew or the vacation. You got your kudos today. I can't wait to see what it looks like. Love the purple in your hair. Thanks, Kathy. Thank you. Yes, you do at 9 o'clock. Okay, where's my, I tried to bring everything down here. So if I forget something, I'll have to pop up and go get it at my table. And my phone is propped up on a mirror with my little whatever that's called on the back pop socket. So if it falls, that's why. Thank you, Carla. Thank you for supporting me. Hey, you're welcome anytime. Are you still wearing your nose ring I sent you, sis? I sent her some lipstick and oops. A nose ring. Hi Janine. I'm just putting powder on, tapping it on for extra coverage and to set that so I don't have such oily skin throughout the day. I did order me a Scarlet concealer so I can highlight. I ordered it last night in my bulk order. I was talking with Kathy Lynch when you popped on. Oh, well hi Kathy Lynch. Join us and say hi. Hey Leanne, hey Kim. Oh, where's my blending bud? I know I just had it. What the what? Oh, right in front of my feet. I'm gonna dampen it with Behold setting spray. And I'm just gonna highlight with my Scarlet concealer. I'm trying to look in the mirror, but I'm trying to look in the phone too, so. Anybody doing anything fun? I'm surprised I have natural light because it is so dreary here. I don't like it. I don't like it. Hi, Diana. Thank you for sharing. Hi, Jennifer. I was watching the West Virginia game, but I get too nervous, so I had to leave. Well, I said when I first got on here, I don't know that I'm going anywhere, but usually when Glenn gets off on a Saturday, we either go eat or something. I wouldn't even mind to go watch the new Peter Rabbit movie because I think it's adorable. This lighting. Ugh, I give up. I give up. We'll just do it at my table from now on and just dealwithit.com. Are you doing anything, sis? Yes, you want to see that movie too. This hair's getting on my nerves. I think it's supposed to go this way. I'm having all sorts of issues today. Could you use rose water to dampen? Yes, ma'am. You sure could. I usually just stick it under the faucet for a second and squeeze it out. But where I was trying to move everything, I forgot to do that. It has rained here all night and still raining. My side yard looks like a pond. Oh my gosh, I bet. That's a lot of rain. Yuck. It's sprinkled here. I don't think it's really come down like a really hard rain. I'll just fix my hair when I'm done. But it's dreary and ugly and it always affects my mood. I'm trying to set up so I can see, you can see me. Getting ready to clean and do something with my Lula room because it looks like it puked. I can't imagine. I cannot imagine. Hey, Andrea. So I'm going to use my beachfront bronzer and I'm going to contour. Contour. This is my fast contour. In my bright light. Whoa. Lesson learned, lesson learned. Hi, Nancy. Did you ever get an email? Is Jaden out of school the 19th? Do I know? I'd have to look at the school calendar. I'll have to look and let you know for sure. What's the 19th? Is it a special day? Is there something I'm not knowing? Fill me in. Ooh, I don't like this setup because I don't have everything where I need it. Not yet. I'm going to call them, Nancy. They're usually really good at getting back, so check your spam, too. Make sure that it didn't go to spam. Hi, Ashley. You're not sure what? It could be like a teacher's thing, and it's not everywhere. Oh, President's Day. Huh. Who knew? But Connie. I don't know. I'll have to look. Does anybody know if Putnam County's out? I'll take care of you, sister, Miss Nancy. I think you done got 3 inches. Blah. That's not good. I'm going to put Behold over my highlighted areas. Do y'all love that I'm so super bright? It's so great. You can barely see anything going on. The store was a killer. We are getting a thunderstorm or something. Ugh. Don't say that. Glenn's out walking in it. That's not fun. Poor little guy. Spirited blush. I'm not using the kudos today. I've used it every day, so I'm going to do something a little bit different. I know. I can't help it. Dealwithit.com, Tammy. I'm in front of the natural lighted window. And yeah. I've done clicked the phone 60 million times and it doesn't change it, so we're dealing with it. I was thinking we could come down Sunday and do Peter Rabbit Monday with the kids. Oh, okay. Then I won't go tonight. You know I can talk to you like that because you're one of us now. So, aren't you lucky, Miss Tam? Aren't you lucky? Let me find my brow artistry brush. Because that's the best thing in the world. Thank you for sharing. I'm trying to sit up, but it's hurting my back. The many struggles of getting ready and trying to look beautimous. Seriously. Thanks, Rita, for sharing. She is so lucky. She is super lucky. She's a part of us. Can y'all see me? I'm lining my brows. I do want to talk about a serious matter, though. How long is it from Dina's house to Missy's house? She knows because she travels it more. It's like almost 2 hours. Yeah, 1 hour and 45 minutes. I don't drive as crazy as she does. Thank you, Destiny, for sharing. Trying to get these brows decent, and I'm not good at multitasking, so like I'm looking at what they're saying and not paying much attention. Do y'all want to talk about a serious matter that's broken my heart this morning? Oh, this lighting. Can y'all hear my music? I'll probably get in trouble. I didn't yesterday though. I'm trying to look and see if my brows are even coming close to, maybe if I do this, pick you up on the way. She's coming from like the Columbus area down. So you had to come up. But Miss Pam's on here, Denai, and she is going to look at Kenny Chesney tickets for us next on Monday. It's nothing wrong with me. It's just life, and I'm really mad about it. I don't know what these brows are doing. Why can't you play music? Because it's copyright, and Facebook will shut you down if you don't say, I don't own the rights to this music. Hi, Mallory. Sweet. Hubby said you could go. Awesome. Okay, now the only thing is, I want to be so close so I can pick his nose. So, you're going to have to start saving some Lula cash. I'm just saying. Hey, Danielle. How are you, girlfriend? I saw you on Kenesha's live earlier. I said hello. Hey, Kim. Yes, I want to pick his nose for him. Wipe the sweat off of him when he gets hot. You know, I'm just polite like that. Yeah, like you asked. Hey, Chrissy. So silly. It is silly. Hi, Chelsea. I want to be as close as I possibly can, so seriously. I might have to leave you all in the nosebleeds if you don't want to pay the price for it. I'll just be like, hi up there. Hope you can see me. I am doing great. Which nose are we picking? Kenny Chesney's. I am such a huge fan. Okay, I'm just going to stop with the brows because it's just getting crazy up in here. Let me find my brush. What? Linda? You like him, don't you? This nasty, but can't help it. Lick the sweat. Don't wipe it. Okay. You don't have to tell me twice. Yeah. Like, seriously, because once you go pit, you don't go back. That's what I always say. And I have gotten so used to it. And the last time that I went and I sat in the nosebleeds, I was like, never again. And my sister knows exactly why. Though, nope. The smelliness was, nope. Not doing it. I'd rather just not go. Just saying. We're cleaning this up with Scarlet Concealer. Because my other one's on the way. Hi, Brittany. Hey, hey. He's okay, but my man is Keith Urban. Now, see, I don't like him. I thought we had so much in common, Miss Linda. I don't care for him. And I definitely don't like his wife. I'm just putting that out there. I was going to say, because if it was Tim McGraw, I've seen Faith Hill fight fans for touching her man. Oh, man. Territorial. Gil wanted me to tell you that he's interviewed Kenny. Well, Miss Connie, you tell Gil that the next time he interviews Mr. Kenny that he needs an assistant for that day, and it's going to be me. Okay, thanks. He is a nice guy because, like I say, he helps everybody down in the Virgin Islands after that storm came through. Hey, Trisha. Hey, Kelly. Yes, Tammy, that is the truth. Hi, April. We're just getting ready. Not doing anything crazy. But we're not using the kudos today. Can you believe I'm not? It's 65% sold out, so if you're wanting to get yours, make sure you get it ASAP. What is wrong? My brows. Let me get my prim liner. Something's up with these crazy, crazy things. Tim McGraw's on my radio right now. Can you hear him? Oh, well. We're just leaving them. We're leaving. I'm not perfect, and neither are my brows, so get with it. Deal with it. He heard your comment. He did? Okay, well, I am his new assistant when that day comes. So he can't back out now. Pull my hair. Okay, so what are we going to do? Let's put this back behind our ear. I'm going to do optimistic, of course, under the brow. Hi, Melissa. You know, me and Gil are like this now, you know. Connie, you have to share with me for a little while. I'll let you let Glenn come over and do your dishes or something. Okay. So we are highlighting under the brow. I'll take pictures when I'm done because, you know, I look more put together once my hair's fixed and I get everything done and get in front of this window and get good lighting. Hey, hey, hi, Beth. That's right, because I'm special like that. Well, at least I like to think so. That's what I like to think. We can pretend. Okay, let's get on this serious matter of bullying, okay? No, nothing has particularly happened to me or to my son, and Brandy just hopped on. So good timing here. Let's talk about bullying. I am not a fan, and I will not put up with it, regardless if it's a kid bullying a kid or if it's actually a parent bullying a kid. Do you know how ridiculous that is? You are a grown woman. Brandy, I'm sick. Like, seriously. If you are a grown adult, leave children alone. Let children fight their own battles until it's not possible for them anymore. And maybe you can go to the adult of the other parent and talk to them or something. If there is such a big problem that you can't control your mouth or your actions. I'm going to use, what is this one? I always forget. Me neither, Brittany. Me either. Gullible. Gullible right here. Gullible. As my breaking crease. So I don't know if I'm allowed to say what happened, but I was talking to Brandy a little bit ago. And seriously, bullying is not okay, and it's getting worse. Cyberbullying is a thing because you can hide behind, hi Glenn, you can hide behind a computer, a phone, a fake name, a fake profile, and you can think that it's so hilarious and that you're downgrading someone else and it's making you feel better because you're having a bad day or you have a reason you think to make someone feel littler or less than what they are. You don't have that right. What gave you that right? In your right mind, you really believe that? Are you proud of yourself for making someone feel less about themselves? You're supposed to lift people up. That's exactly what I try to do. And no, not everybody's perfect. And yes, I make fun of people that have on a stupid outfit or that their butt crack's hanging out or that their hair looks like they just got out of bed and they're at Walmart. I make fun of that. I do. I'm human. I do. But I'm not going to carry it to the next stage that I'm going to find them on social media and I'm going to completely tell them what a piece of crap they are and how in the world could you live with yourself because you have your butt crack hanging out. No, it's not bullying, but it can go further than that by, you know, making fun of them in public with friends and whatever, and then it escalating, and you know, if you knew the person, and it getting worse and worse and worse, and you're making these people feel bad about themselves, and telling them that they're worthless and that they shouldn't be around. You have a so-called brother-in-law loves to bully, but I can tell he don't bully me, but he only liked to. I hate that. I mean, what gives him the right to? I know that may be your relatives or your family. But what gives him, why is he so much better that he can tell somebody? You know, how's he going to feel when that person that he keeps doing that to takes their own life? Because they feel, well, maybe that person's right. I'm taking Rapturous. I'm going to go over here because I can't see. And put it on my lid. And then we'll blend it out. What happens when that person that they were bullying takes their life? Are they going to be proud of themselves and say, good, I told you you weren't worth being around. I'm so glad that he listened to me or she listened to me. Because he's crazy. My neighbor is a bully. I've dealt with it for almost a year. It's broken me. Even affected my daughters. Now, see, that's ridiculous. That's unacceptable. And someone needs to put them in their place. I mean, they really do. I think it's ridiculous. And what's the point? Now, if somebody does something to you and they're constantly doing it, I absolutely expect you to stand up for yourself. But there's a line that you cross. Oh, I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to. Oh, well. We'll take that off because I'm putting rapturous under there. Creature of habit, and I'm talking. You can't stand him and he knows it. But seriously, like, what do they get out of that? I have never understood. Yes, when I was in grade school, and it was before, like, bullying really became a thing, and I was shying backwards, but there was this girl that was had less, and kind of smelled sometimes, and at one point we all made fun of her. It didn't last very long because the teacher stopped it and we felt bad for doing this. Yes, your neighbor was, for sure, sis. I've called my landlord bawling my eyes out, but nothing has been done. I don't know what they could do. You know, I mean, what do you do? I don't know. But if you have a child, I don't care if they're still in your house or in grade school or they're 18 or whatever it may be, talk to them. Please tell them that bullying is not okay and that people's opinions about them do not define who they are, because someone's life was taken because they were bullied by an adult. I mean, how ridiculous is that? An adult could actually upset a child so much that that person, that child... Oh, thank you. I do too. I love, it is rapturous. Let me put this right back here. But seriously, what in your right mind is, why is that okay? Why is that okay, what you just did? And do you have remorse? Do you wish you wouldn't have done it? I'm at a loss for words. As a mother of an only son, it's horrible. I put myself in her shoes this morning, and my heart breaks for her. My heart truly aches, and I'm like, what can I do to help her? Well, there's nothing you can do. You know, her son is gone now. You can't replace him. There's no fixing that. And someone is responsible for it. Yes, he ultimately took his own life, but because someone was treating him that way. Hey, Emily. She doesn't, Tammy. Can't imagine a child being in that frame of mind that they would take their life. Yeah, it happens every single day. Like, I've seen grade school children do it. I mean, how do they even know to do that? The internet? Cyberbullying is now illegal in West Virginia. Awesome. That's amazing. 16, Tammy. I'm just talking about cyberbullying, whether it be a child to a child, a child to an adult, or an adult to a child. It's wrong. It's completely and totally wrong. I don't care who you are, what you're doing. It's not okay. And somebody's life has been taken because they started believing the bully. And it was a young life. Hi, Amy. Anybody who messes with me or my kids, they have had a bad day. Yeah, I agree. That's when the Dorsey comes out in me. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's what I was saying yesterday. So this kind of ties along. This is rapturous. 11 or 12-year-old Milton girl recently took her life. It's getting younger and younger. It is. It is. Like I say, I've heard of grade school. Like, grade school kids. Because they were getting bullied by other kids. Whether it's they don't have as much as they do, or you're fat, or you're ugly, or... I like put a papa collar on here. It's purple. But they do. They bully them and they think it's funny and it makes them look big and cute. And granted, my son has been bullied too at school. But we try to talk to him and let him know, you know, these people aren't worth hurting you over. say whatever and don't let it sink in. But, you know, we all do. Yeah, it's really sad, Linda. Yeah, they haven't gotten to live yet. They don't know, you know, they will never experience getting graduating, getting their first job, getting married, having children. I mean, all that's gone. And then their parents are left with that. This mother was very involved, and she immediately addressed this, and it still happened. But don't think your kids are immune to it. No, don't think you. It can't happen to you. And that's what scares the crap out of me, because Jaden is so sensitive. I don't know, Pam. I've known of teachers that bully kids, and that, oh, that's horrible. That is, they shouldn't even teach them. I mean, I have a friend that killed himself. He hung himself, and he was in his 30s. And his mom and his dad, that was their only child, and I love them to pieces, and I still talk to them to this day. They're from the Sissonville area where I lived after I started my life over. And it's never left me, so I can only imagine how those parents feel. So it's absolutely horrible and devastating. And as a mother of a hey Marsha, as a mother of an only child and a son, I don't understand. I mean, I can see where they feel like that is the only option, but do you know, they don't think about how it leaves their family so lost, and so many questions answered, and so it devastates their life and changes it forever. So that's something that you can't change. You can't take that back, and gosh, it's so sad. Teach your kids at a young age bullying is not okay. It is. It's something that you do teach them, but you know, we all know that even if you teach your children, they've still got their own minds, and they still got to deal with things emotionally inside. Permanent solution to it. Yes, and I think that, you know, I'm cruel when I say this, but I think that, looking for a liner shader brush while I'm talking. I think that, and I'm a judge, I'm not a judge, but I do. I think that that's the easy way out. Like, I think it's cowardly, and I think it's selfish when someone knows that what they're doing and they take their own life because they're only thinking about themselves at the time. But when they're in that state of mind, I mean, they know on a daily basis, you know, if I did this, my family would be devastated. But when they're in the situation and they don't know where else to turn or what else to do, they don't feel that. They don't see that, and they don't think that. They just want to end it. They want to think, I need to get out of this, and this is my only option. At that time, you feel so low and that nobody cares about you, that that's your only option, and you're going to think, they don't care if I'm here or I'm not. People are mean, but it's all learned behavior. That's a sad thing. Either they are seeing it from family or friends. Yeah, and it, like I say, it gets worse as we go, because the parents these days do it and they think it's funny, and then the kids pick up on it and they don't discipline them, because how could they? They do it. But it's just really, really, after talking to Brandy this morning, I mean, I put myself in somebody else's shoes when they are hurting. It's something I learned in church. One guy stood up and was a preacher, and he said, you know, don't judge someone until you put yourself in, take yourself out of your comfortable shoes and put yourself in their uncomfortable shoes, because that's when you're going to feel what they feel before you judge them. My own mother committed suicide. It is very selfish, hurts everyone, and ends their pain only. Yeah, I agree, and it's hard. I can't stand to see men or women in a store being mean to their children. Oh my gosh, I know. I can't either. I just want to say something to them. Unless the children is acting up, then you've got to discipline. Kids can't even imagine how final it is. That's true. Yeah, that's true too. They're not thinking rationally at that time. No, they aren't. They aren't at all. Because at that time, they're in that situation. They're just like, I mean, I'll be honest. I've been in a situation where I thought, this is it. I can't do it. Nobody else cares about me. Would I ever actually follow through and do it? No. No, because especially now that I have a son, you know, I could not leave him, and I could not now that I know what my best friend did to his parents, no, I could never. But there's times when you do feel so low and like nobody else cares about you, especially if you suffer from depression. I mean, I can see it. I truly, truly can. And I really suffer a lot as a Christian thinking, how can they be, if they take their own life, how do they make it to heaven? That's something I don't know the answers to. I know once you're saved, you're always saved. That's how I feel. You might not get the riches that you would if you were living the straight and narrow and doing everything the right way. But, you know, those are broad things and those are my opinions. That was, I used Magnificent cream shadow on my eyes, and then I did pencil liner Imperfect, which is black, on my waterline. But those are just my opinions, and I forgot to bring lipstick over here, so I'll have to get up in a second. I can assure you that this child wasn't in the frame of mind to realize what it would do to his absolutely he wasn't, or he wouldn't have done it. Because, like I say, they are pushed and pushed and pushed. And that emotion just takes over. And all of a sudden, it's just like, that's the only thing you can think of. And you just do it. I know, Brittany. I struggle with that. Especially after my best friend took his life. And I don't even know if he was saved before. You know, I would venture to say no. But I'm not the judge. I can't. I'm going to blend out my face before I get up and get some lipstick. I would venture to say he wasn't, and he is probably not where I want to think he is, but we all hope for the best. You know, we aren't the judge, we aren't the jury, we don't know. We just hope and keep that peace of calm mind to get through life after it happens, for sure. I cannot believe you earned the trip last month. Oh, thanks, Jordan. Yeah, it was like a few days into February, actually, so I'm so excited. But thank you. I hope you're there with me. Brandy, I know, after talking to Brandy, I was brokenhearted. Because, like I say, I put myself in their shoes, and it's just, what if that was my son? What if that was my life? Gosh. I mean, you can't imagine. You can't put yourself in their shoes. You can't feel that pain. You can't. Yeah, you have to get yourself through the life. You have to say, you know what, if you don't know for sure, you have to be a positive and you have to tell yourself, well, I hope that they did the right thing. I hope they were saved. I hope that I will see them in heaven. And keep that thought in your mind, because it, you know, that will eat you alive if otherwise. If you think, I'll never see them again, what they're actually doing if they're not in heaven. Gosh. How old was your friend? Someone asked. My friend that took his life in his 30s. I've been that alone before, and it's not a good feeling, and you don't want to bother people. Yeah, you think that you are a burden to them. And you're not. If you only knew, like Michelle, my gosh, we just met you, what, 2 months ago? And I would do anything for you, sister. I mean, you just, but at that time, you don't think that. A 16-year-old took his life because he was being cyberbullied, Marsha. Like my friend, I will tell you, and it's like that crying wolf. Have you ever heard of that? Like, when you, and it's an attention thing, and you think, oh my gosh, whatever, I'm not dealing with it anymore. Like, my best friend threatened suicide a couple times on me. Well, the first couple times I was like, okay, I can't either, Brittany. It does. Suicide, that is a good way to look at it. It does transfer the pain and puts that on somebody else. Absolutely. Because you feel like, I should have done something. You blame yourself even though it wasn't your fault. Broke up with him and he was only 17. See, it's everywhere. It is everywhere. But my friend, I was probably 29 or 30 when this happened, I think. I don't remember. And my daddy called me at work and said, hey, did you hear about it? It was Jason Taylor. And I was like, no, what did he do stupid now? Because he always just, he was just a fly by the seat of his pants, silly kind of guy, but he would have done anything for me, anything. I said I wanted a grill one time and he was going to go buy me a grill. I'm like, no, I don't, you know, I don't want you to do that. I was just saying I would like to have one. He spoiled me. We weren't dating. We were best friends. And like, he literally spoiled me. And he had just a few little issues, nothing that people don't face. And he threatened a couple times and I've chased him down and, you know, I talked him out of it. And I made him stay at my house. And then after a while, you're like, I can't keep doing this. This is like exhausting and draining to me. And I have issues and problems of my own. I can't keep doing this. He's just looking for attention. Well, that's the crying wolf thing. Crying wolf, crying wolf, crying wolf. And so eventually, then I started seeing Glenn, and I didn't hang out with him as much because, like I said, it was just pulling all of me out. 15 and 17, that's just stupid. I just, so sad. Yes, Angela, I do too. I go to the doctor every year, and I want to change doctors because she's not there. We always used to catch up, and it's not the same. It's not the same. But, so I was seeing Glenn, and it was early in our relationship, and I got a phone call from Jason. And he said, hey, Missy, I'm in trouble. Can you come and get me? I don't have a way home. So Glenn and I hopped in my car, and we went to pick him up. And we took him to where he wanted to be for the night, and we dropped him off. Did it cause problems between Glenn and I because I dropped everything and went and picked him up? Yes, it did. But he was my best friend, so I felt like if he called me, he needed me. So I went. I'm going to put Epic over top of this. And the next day while I was at work, he called and left a message on my answering machine. Yes, we had answering machines. And he said, Missy, I'm sorry I caused any issues between you and Glenn. If you forgive me, please call me back. Okay, well, I got busy and I never called him back. Needless to say, a few weeks later, he was gone. And I didn't have that opportunity to call him and say, hey, I'm sorry I didn't call you. I did forgive you. It wasn't a big deal. We got over it. I'm always here for you. So he took his own life, not because of me, for other reasons, thinking that I didn't forgive him. And I always second guess myself and feel bad for that. Angela, you can't blame yourself. You can't. I mean, it's just, like I say, she probably would have never done it in her right mind, but at that time she had been just pushed and pushed and pushed and pushed and pushed. And you can't. You just can't blame yourself, girlfriend. You just can't. I know we feel the need to, but when they're at that stage, there's nothing that you could personally do. Hey, Rhonda, I'm going to use iridescent powder. And I'm going to highlight. But just please, if you're listening to me today and you have children, even if you have an adult that suffers from depression or worries about what people think, please go and talk to them and tell them about this. It's not worth taking your own life. Hold on. I'm going to get up and get me some lipstick. Yes, I'm still in my pajama bottoms. Don't judge. Oh, where is my lipstick? I'll be right back. Sorry, guys. Did you see my nice plaid pajama pants? We're going to do splash, and I'm going to do a couple of colors. So please, ladies and gentlemen, don't think you're not worth it, because you truly are. What? Okay, here comes my blind self again. I think these are the colors I wanted. So that's my spiel. Just know that you are important and that somebody out there truly cares about you, no matter who it is or what it is Reach out to somebody. Please talk to them. You are worth it. You are God's child. He made you for a special reason. Don't let somebody else take that from you. Okay, this is Stoic. I mean, God thought you were good enough for Him to create. And He gave His only Son for you. So He thought you were pretty special. So you are. Stoic, and I'm lining my lips with it. Yes, me too, girl. I'm always here. We all have our issues and our problems in life, but you know, helping somebody else or talking to somebody else about theirs can also help you. I know so many people hold their feelings in and don't express their hurts or their problems with anybody because they feel like they're a burden and, oh, they have their own issues. They don't want to know about me. Yeah, I know. It's because I'm sitting down low. You can swipe to the right and it'll take them all off. If any of you are interested, there is a link on my Facebook page for GoFundMe account. Will help. I will absolutely do that, Brandy. I'm not a fan of GoFundMe because I've always heard that they take part of it. But helping out is the only thing to do. Yes, look Brandy up if you want to help. That's what I asked her this morning. I know that whatever I can do is nothing compared to what she needs. She just needs prayer. Okay, that's Stoic. I'm going to dust my brush off. This is liquid lipstick, and I'm using a cream shadow brush to put it on with. We have a lip brush, but where I'm not at my normal station, I just grabbed everything. And then this is, I think it's Sublime. I can't see the bottom very good. Yes, praying is always free. As a matter of fact, it is. And it helps. God hears. If you're saved, God hears your prayers. I think it's hard sometimes when you don't have friends or someone to turn to. I have no friends here, only back home. Suicide is never the answer. I wish she could have seen that. I read her last words and cried to read what she was thinking. See, I never did hear her last words, Angela. I never did. But, I talked to a few people that were around her that night. And thank you, Rita. Angela is talking about a girl I graduated high school with that took her life over a relationship issue. And I'm just putting this in the center. And we all miss her terribly, seriously. I mean, I may have seen her once or twice a year, but I still miss her. Okay, and then I'll have to fix my hair again because it's in my way. And this is the look for the day. I may add a little bit more brown to the outer V. I think I might just do that. Now that I've spoke and probably put everybody in a solemn mood, I'm so sorry. I did not mean to do that, but it's something that needs to be addressed. It seriously needs to be addressed. Hi, Jessica. Hi, Melissa. Hi, Noelle and Nikki. So if you're just catching this, watch the replay, please, and talk to those you love. Talk to them. Let them know you're there. And never think that you're a burden to anybody if it's your issue. But you're not. You may think that, but you're not. Someone will always stop and take time to listen. And if it's not the first person you reach out to, that's okay. Find somebody else. Keep talking until you find that person that's going to listen to you. And it may be a stranger. And sometimes strangers are the best people to talk to because they don't know your background. They don't know all of the stuff you're going through and judge. Well, you shouldn't be with that person anyway if it's a friend like that. If you are with them, then you're stupid. You know, those kinds of things. Thank you. Thanks, Melissa. I'm just adding a little bit of dark brown in the outer corner because, you know, that's my creature of habit in me. Yes, that's true, Brittany, because people do not talk about it enough. It's like one of those things you're afraid to say anything. Don't be afraid to talk about it. I mean, if people judge me for how I feel and hear about it right now, that's okay. I still love you. Like I said yesterday, I agree to disagree with you. This is my feelings and my opinions, so by all means, that's your opinion. And we all have them. We all truly have them. So it's okay to disagree with mine. But that's just how I feel. And I think that we should, you know, we can't read if somebody is going to do that. But like me, I kept getting someone that was crying wolf, and I eventually just said, you're just blowing smoke up my butt. No, he wasn't. I honestly think that he was still crying wolf when it happened, and he was out of control. He couldn't do anything about it. Need to put groceries up, and nice ladies, glad I was here to discuss this. It does need to be talked about. Hiding this doesn't help. Put up those groceries, Miss Pam. All right, so this is my look for the day. I'm going to take some pictures after I fix this hairdo again, and I'll post them for you. So if anybody has any questions, anybody needs to reach out and talk to me about an issue, you know I'm here all the time. Just message me. A lot of people do, Marsha. A lot of people hold it in. And I do to an extent, and I'll express it in other ways, but it's raining again. I just think that it's easier for me to not tell anybody because I feel like, who cares? They're going to say, oh, how are you? Well, I'm down today. Oh, okay, great. But if you tell somebody, I really have a problem, I really need your help, tell them that. And then they're going to listen to you. Well, I hope you guys have an amazing Saturday and Sunday, and I'll see you back here Monday at 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Go see my sister tonight on her LuLaRoe site, Dina Brown, and she'll be on at 9 o'clock p.m. tonight on a Saturday. So go party with her and get you some nice clothes to go with your beautiful makeup. Don't forget that our kudos is 65% sold out. It will not last probably another week. So if you want that, go to MissyBowls.com, click shop, and click kudos. Pick it out. $67 you get the palette, a brush, and a lip bonbon. I will talk to you guys soon. Have a great day. Love you. Thank God for your blessings and for each healthy person that is in your life tonight. I will talk to you guys later. Bye. Thanks, sissy.